What's up, everyone? Joshua here. We got a new video. Vince has got a couple fish. We got a beginner here, and we're gonna show you guys how to clean fish as a beginner. So Vince took his time yesterday, got us some fish. Thank you, Vince, and taking the time out of your day to get us this fish. But you guys are in for a real special treat. We've got a new beginner here, Matthew, and Vince caught us, looks like, what do we got, six, Vince?
Got six.
And Vince is going to start explaining this to you, so I'm just going to hand it over. Matthew, if you want to start.
Absolutely. So I'm here with Captain Russo. Captain, what fish are we working on today?
Speckled trout.
Speckled trout. All right. Well, I've never worked with a speckled trout, so I will be asking you a lot of questions.
Good. Good. All right, let's plug in. We're going to scale, show you how to. You can scale them by hand, or you can get you an electric scale.
Vince, before you start, go over why you gut them and why you don't, and show us whole thing that you were telling us.
Okay.
And if you're still shooting live, yeah, I've noticed that five of the six fish are gutted, so definitely would like to talk about that process.
Okay, I've told people before, one of my pet peeves is what we try to teach people with our videos is cleaning fish for maximum return. It's not taking a fish like this and coming out with a strip of bacon. We want the baby to eat at the house. Now, a lot of fishermen will go out, they'll ice the fish down with one bag of ice. Put plenty of ice, layer your ice with your fish. If you come in the evenings, you're not gonna clean your fish, just take a simple task in gutting that fish. And when you take that little main entrail out, I'll show you if it's in this one like it usually is, depending on what side you put the fish down on, you'll have a bladder inside of it that will cause that fish to stain. And at that spot, it's bitter. I'm gonna cut this one out. Matthew, you wanna come around the other side here?
Yes, sir.
And you'll see, I'm gonna come up right through here. Notice I put my index finger right here. This is becoming an extension of the nerve and the tip of my finger. Like if you got a splinter, you can feel it real easy, right, on your finger. All right, this is why this little guard is on this knife. This curved edge, I'm just gonna gut it as if I did last night. I reach in, I grab that, and I cut that main entrail out. And that's all I did last night. Now, you see that yellow spot? I'm gonna go ahead. We're gonna come back to this one in a minute, and I'm gonna show you what happened last night on this fish because I did not gut it like I want you to do. Okay? All right. A lot of people, why do you scale it if you're gonna skin it? Hey, we like to keep things clean. You notice I wash down a lot. I like to scale it. I don't like any scales left over. No matter how well you think you're going to rinse it, the more you're putting that meat in water, the more you're making that meat get mushier. And it's not as firm and it's not as nice. All right, I also have people, and I agree with them, a lot of people say that they would rather clean a fish after it's been iced down. That's true. The meat is firmer and is easier to cut. Now, 99% of the time when I get back, we have a live well in our boat, and if you can see that container off the dock over there, we put our fish in that and to keep them alive. I like to clean my fish alive. Now, I had a gentleman yesterday, his name was Craig Fitzgerald. He called me from Texas. He asked me, do I bleed my fish? I don't bleed my small fish like this because we are keeping them alive. We aren't taking them and coming in with the ice chest and doing it the next day. Now, and they'll get mushy if you don't drain the cooler. When I ice it, I pull the plug, and I cock it and let all that water drain out. I don't get it sitting in that ice. He bleeds trout, he bleeds his flounder, he also bleeds reds.
Why would he bleed them?
His reason for bleeding those is kind of like, and I've never done it because I've done mine alive. If you take tuna, you take a fish of that line, like, oh gosh, I'm drawing a blank here right now. Bonita, those type of fish. It's a darker fish, you want to bleed it, and it gets that bloodline out, and it tastes better. And he says that there's a difference in the color of his meat when he bleeds his flounder and his trout and his reds, and you know, gives it a better clean. Now, I'm gonna go through this on the two things on this fish. I'm gonna scale it. First of all, I'm gonna scale one. I'm gonna scale this one, just a basic hand scaler that we have, you know, on our site. And just, you hold it up into here, and you just come along. Get up next to the shells, scales there, the dorsal fin, come all the way around, particularly for layer fish. Now, some people want you not to throw anything away, and they want this collarbone in it. We don't take the collarbone and leave it in our fillets. It's not that much because we get so much more back. All right, and then once this is scaled, then I come back and I'm rinsing everything down. Now, the way the business is done we take, where was that one that I had over there? Okay, good. Now, this is a little electric scale. This is kind of a mini version, and I'm gonna let you price with this in a minute, of the big one also in the business. All right, well, I tell you what, let's work on this side. Now, this won't hurt, but if you hit your fingernail, it can take it off. We had a guy in our business, he was looking through the window at the girl coming in the front door one day, and it hit his finger. Enoch went to the doctor. We got a call an hour later, Enoch was dead. He was allergic to penicillin and they didn't know it. Just because he ripped his fingernail off. My daddy always says, you don't get a second chance. I tuck my thumb away and all you do is just roll it up like that. Come like that. Just come down. And you're done. This is a neat little product. This is called a bear claw. I'm not sponsored by any of these people, but it works well. I do have a problem with this bracket that they put on it. I take this one on because I lost one overboard, and they didn't want to give me another one one day. They like, okay, but they sent one anyway. They were real nice about that. Okay.
Can you get that on Amazon?
I'm not sure. Okay, now. You want me now to go ahead and do the rest of them, Josh? Or just do a couple like that and I'll come and clean
Matthew,
it up?
I want to see Matthew.
Okay, yeah, I want to do that as well. All right, Matthew, you want to start off with the hand scale or the electric scale?
I'm going to do the hand scale.
Okay.
Do it old school. I figured let me start slow.
That's good.
All right.
Let's see what he can do.
So let me just see.
You go ahead. I'm going to stand. There you go. That's it. Perfect. How's it feel?
I mean, it's kind of scaly, but you can kind of, the good thing is, you know, for being a novice, I can feel when I get close to the scales, I can tell when I'm getting rid of them.
Yep, come up underneath that fin. Mm-hmm. Yeah, get it all.
You can tell when it's done.
Like, exactly. Like, it's kind of a gradual feeling. I kind of relate it to shaving. Okay. As far as, you know, you can kind of tell once you've been there long enough.
Okay, now, hold up just a minute. You want to get here and around all these fins because you're going to be cutting in that section. And
gotcha.
If you don't get your scales off, the knife will jump and it could cut your finger.
Good to know.
All right, and I'll show you another thing we'll do at one time. If we find a flounder, we can do a whole flounder we can get.
Oh, I love flounder. When I was a kid, I got to go flounder gigging a little bit.
All right. That's it. Get it all. Get all along that dorsal fin really well on both sides. Pull back, because that's where you're going to be cutting again. You don't want that knife to skip on that spot.
Yes, sir.
Good to know. And that's why we're scaling this.
Well, yeah. I like to have the scales off. A lot of people don't want to have it. And you can still see, because it's shiny right there, mm-hmm. You still got scales. Come on up in there. There you go. Use that tip as much as you can. Come around. I say just move from one side and just keep rolling the fish. Right, come on, right, come on top of the head. Right here. There you go. All right, get back to one more place you missed, I saw. Get back all up under the section right here.
Yes, sir.
And it's a lot easier if I am scaling my fish out here on the dock when I'm cleaning them. I use an electric scaler, get them all knocked off. I come back and rinse them, then I hit them and gut them and do the rest of it.
All right, okay. Give it a wash down. Let me see how I did. All right.
Let me look
Captain,
at it.
Let's see what we did.
All right, right here.
Okay,
you left a little bit right there,
yes, sir.
But everything else, everything else is seems to be pretty good. Yeah, a little bit up underneath here, and that's about it.
Okay, dope.
Okay, all right. Now, you want to try one with this?
I'm good either way. I mean,
okay.
I saw how fast it was, so.
All right.
And I'm allergic to penicillin, too. Sean actually got a hold. Yeah? All right.
All right, Josh, what you want to do next?
Let's start cutting.
All right. Okay, now. Let's take, where was that fish we had a second ago? Was it, look, I can tell by this looking at that. Yeah, right here. Okay, now, this fish was gutted, this fish is what? I'm going to do a couple and then we got plenty here for Matthew to jump in on. Now, in the business, normally what we would do, we'd come up and we'd cut the head off like this. Right in this spot, it's like a soft spot. Watch how lightly I hold my hand on this knife. Look how it just goes right through that.
Yes, sir.
I didn't probably put any pressure. If you come up here, it's going to be a little tough. And then we cut in a C motion. And the reason we cut in a C motion is we want as much meat up in that head as you possibly can get, okay? And then we come back, cut right above the anal fin, and we cut into the kidney. Scrape this, and see where I'm always keeping my finger on that blade. I want to be able to feel. And then I trim that off, okay?
Okay, now. On. Let's stop it. Let's get him to that point.
Okay.
Let's get him to that point. Hey, we got some fans over here.
Yeah, that's all my damn.
These are your fans?
Give me program. Here we go.
Yeah.
Looking for that free hand out. Okay, now.
Let's see Matthew.
All right, let me do one more.
Okay.
And then we'll get on. We'll let Matthew get next. Now, the reason I want to do this, Josh, zoom in on that. See that spot?
Yep.
That's a rotten part of the fish there. Because it wasn't gutted the night before.
Mm-hmm.
See, that side is okay. The bladder was lying down in that direction.
Mm-hmm.
See what I was talking about, Matthew?
That yellow spot.
Okay. Now, I'll go ahead and let you.
Okay. So
I'll let you go ahead and work on that.
So first thing I'm going to do, though, having listened, I'm going to make sure I get my finger where I know exactly where it is.
Right.
All right. Now this is where
Now come back.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Let me kind of.
Yes, sir.
I'm gonna hold your hand and
kind
of guide you.
Mm-hmm.
All right, come back like this.
Mm-hmm.
Now, does that salt fit? How it went
yes,
through
sir.
Real easy. Okay, now come on around and cut down. Now, at this point,
I feel like I'm on something hard now.
Now you go ahead, cut through. There you go. Now, you at that point you can take your finger off the index.
Uh-huh.
It would be easier for you to cut and see. You would get a little bit more head meat, not
mm-hmm.
much. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now.
Thanks.
Now laying it down.
Yes, sir.
On the side. Take your knife. Cut always with this curved part of the knife.
Mm-hmm.
Cut above that anal fin right there. Cut right above that.
And
yeah.
Cut down this way?
Come on back a little bit more.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, that's good. Whoa, stop.
Yes, sir. Stop.
Now go ahead and scrape out the bladder. And then.
I'd be the same way.
All right, now. Cut out with the curved part of your blade and get the. No, pull it just like that.
Yes,
yeah.
sir.
Okay. Now, taking this knife like as if it was kind of a spoon, scrape down and scrape all that blood out.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what is this doing, Vince? Explain this to us.
You're removing the blood, the kidney out of the thing. Yeah, you'll keep going. That's it.
Just remove it.
Just kind of stop right here,
mm-hmm.
hold it, and rake it. See how you
yeah,
get
that was a whole different sound when
yeah.
I did that.
Yeah, well, you're cutting there now. You're cutting both. Just want to stick in that, right in this, wait a minute, right here in that center and scrape down.
Gotcha. Now, that's very specific. Thank you. All right. Slow it down some. I'm having to slow down. I was trying to be fast, but I was messing up.
No, you want to learn to take baby steps. Okay, let's go ahead and rinse it out, and I'll show you what. But you see how soft that meat is?
Oh, it's very tender.
It's ruined. You ruined that. I ruined that fish's side right there. Okay, now I'm going to clean it.
So that's a do not side
right there. Right. If you're not going to clean the fish that day, go ahead and gut them.
You can
see it, and you can also feel it as well.
You can see it.
Okay, now. See that? See how firm that side is? See that mushy that side is? We'll trim that off just a little bit now. Okay.
So now what did we just do? Cut the head off, and then we remove the kidney and the blood.
You clean all the inside. I got all the intestines out of the inside, okay? Now, I don't know if you can tell it, Matthews, but you can almost feel this is a firmer flesh.
No, it feels denser, heavier.
Yeah,
almost.
And feel right in here. Feel at it.
Why does it feel tougher?
Because it's not spoiled. Now see that.
Mm-hmm.
See, touch that right. See how soft and mushy
it's
that
very
is.
Very soft and mushy. That's much
basic,
harder.
Yeah, right.
I can literally feel the difference. Harder
yeah,
and softer.
Right. So you don't want to leave that bladder in there. You want to get those entrails out if you're not doing it that same day. And even if you put it in an ice chest, ice it down well enough. Just don't buy one bag of ice. You got more ice on the beer than you got on the fish. And people don't understand the merchandise. Is more expensive than a bag of ice. Okay. All right. Now come around on my other side,
yes,
and I'll show you that.
What are we doing
on this side? What we're gonna do? I'll work on this one right here.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna work off the edge, and these fish are from last night. They're a little bit slippery on this board. I'm gonna lay this tile down, which I do a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, taking the index finger and I'm holding it at that point, and I'm cutting always with the curved edge of the knife, and get. That's why I have thousands of fish in my life. You come above this bone section right here, this backbone. Then you come forward with the curved edge again. Very easy on trout. It's a little more difficult on a red. And you come down to the end and you cut through. Then you turn around again. Now, another thing to remember, everybody's always watching the knife and what the knife is doing. There's also a lot done with this left hand. You apply a little pressure down on the left hand, You start to cut right there. Now I'm gonna pull through with this. Now you watch, this is why it's important. Always I tell you to get scales away from there as well. Put my index finger here, cutting with this part of the knife, put a little pressure on your left side. Watch this meat just roll up.
It just curved right out.
Yep. See that? You already cut away that top fillet, right?
See that?
Oh, wow, that is beautiful.
Now, you got a nice fat
wow
piece. Now, when you run, let me get some here really close here. When you run an electric knife down, you see that gap? Mm-hmm. See that gap on that vertebrae? The vertebrae shape like that. Here it is right here, okay? That meat here and that meat here, and if you don't want to nip the top of that bone, you up here, well, you're leaving all that mm-hmm on the fillet. Mm-hmm. Okay?
You cut around that.
Right.
That's, you carved around that.
So now we come back.
The backside.
We lay this down, apply a little down pressure again, come over this fin, pull it through, and you'll get that bone off, that anal fin off. Okay? Now, we're down to this much.
Hold on, this is a lot of steps. Should we stop and have him do his
Let me finish the whole one and we'll do another.
Okay, and then we'll break it down.
Then I'll be slow and do mine.
All right, now, again, and I don't know if you can see it, but it's a little wiggly. Dorsal fin, I'm trying to give you anatomy lesson so you kind of know where you're. That dorsal fin right there mm-hmm is going into that main backbone. Okay. So you want to go over it, apply pressure with your left hand, come all the way back. And you want to kind of do it in a seesaw motion. You don't want to push and pull, okay? Then as you get up here, come over again, come down on the other side of that vertebra, and then you just go right forward like that. And then you just got that on your backbone, and you don't have all that meat left on it.
Wow. That is perfect.
Now Monica's got some shots out here at night with a redfish that she held up to the light and you can see right on through it. Now, I just noticed just then that knife was not as sharp and I didn't start off before I started this.
Oh yeah, we didn't sharpen it.
Uh-oh. I always keep my copperundum stone on my dock. Quick. And you always want your knife, Matthew, to be flat. You don't want to put it on an angle like this. Mm-hmm. You want to go back and forth. Knock off that edge, same thing on this side. When I was a kid, every hardware store you went into had a sharpening stone sitting there.
Huh.
They call it a whetstone.
Yes.
With oil. Pull it back.
They had it there just so people could walk in.
Oh gosh, everybody carried
knives?
A pocket knife in their pocket. Okay. All right, let's get back over here on this. Now, we cut this fish off. This head off on these fish, we cut them off in a C-section. Mm-hmm. Normally what I do, like on this one, and we're gonna do some more so we can come back on it. I'd come back this way on average, because I'm not worried about wasting a little bit of meat in a carbine. I cut it on an angle this way, then I come back and I remove that head like that, okay? And then I come back and I take and scrape all this off. Right. Okay, now.
Do that again. Do that head cut again because I missed it.
See, that's much better looking there. All right, now, what was it, Josh, you want
what
me to do?
Say about the head again. Do that again.
Well, you can cut the head off in a C motion like this.
Okay.
And we in the business, what we would do, people want as much meat as they pay for. If they buy a fish in the scale and they send it through the wind and have it clean in the back, they don't want to have a little bit of meat coming back. Mm-hmm. The best way to get it is already get it prepackaged in the fillet on the counter, right?
Because you're just paying for
what? Now, what we would do when I was coming, we come back, we take this, we trim that off. We'd even go so far as to take, this thing's slipping around on me on this wet board today. We would take this fin and we would roll it like this. And we would just come around in a circle and take that main bone out. And the only bone you would have in your fillet when you gut it would be this heavy collarbone, which has a lot of meat. Kind of tastes like the wing of a chicken. It's a tender type meat. It really tastes good. And you get big fish like grouper and all that, people will cut the throats out and they'll cut the cheeks out and all because it's a tender piece. Now, when you get to this point, You take your knife, and I had a guy one day, he didn't realize I was turning the knife upside down. He couldn't understand how I was cutting it this way. Turn your knife upside down, you get under those rib cage bones, and I don't know if you can see, but you can almost see, Josh, between the knife and the, and you can almost see the knife through those bones.
Yep.
Come through like that, and come up. And you take your knife, and you want to take that left hand again. That left hand's very important. And you want to kind of feel that you're rubbing up next to those bones and draw a straight line. Now, I know these trolls are going to tell me how many fish they can clean with an electric knife.
Wow.
And how fast they are, but I'm doing this as an instructional video. I'm not doing this to show you how fast I can do it. Now, on every fish here, that little line, see that little line right there, Matthew?
Yes,
all right, that little line, you get, there's bones that run back down inside the high side of the fish. So you come back in on that, and then you come back in on the other side, and you take your hand as a pair of pliers and your thumb, and you just pull that center bone right out. Okay, now that's how we would put fillet fish up to most people, and they knew that main bone would be in there. But in this situation, we want to eat it like a banana and enjoy it, and we're going to come back and take all that off, okay, like that. So there isn't any bones at all in there. And then,
beautiful looking
fillet. Now, if somebody wants to have the skin off, we always fried our fish as kids with the skin on. Then we come back. I got this little bottle cap thing I made here. Hold the tail down. Take what we call a boning knife. And we skin our smaller trout with that. You hold the tail. I put my index finger here this time, and I just do a little seesaw back and forth like that.
Is there any special way you're feeling where the skin is? Like, how do you know where the meat is?
Well, you get the feel on it. These knives, when you buy them, when I have them, they're super sharp right out of the package. It's very hard for somebody like yourself who's never cleaned a fish before not to cut through that skin. And actually, if it's a little dull,
might be
it works better,
better for a beginner.
Yeah, it does. Now, see that? That looks like a snake.
It was as thin as a piece of paper, so
yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
You really got
and then,
under the skin.
And then you don't have any skin on it, if that's what you want, okay? Let me run aside and put this down.
All right, guys, I know you're watching, so if you have any questions, please feel free to ask while we got the captain here.
Okay, I'm going to do another one, then we'll let you jump on the whole fish,
right,
okay?
Sounds good.
Trying to see what else. Our little sea trout, Marquand asked.
Yes, speckled sea trout. Different regions of the countries call them different things, like redfish. We always called our redfish spot-tail bass, and then channel bass, and then all these redfish tournaments started coming about, and everybody knows them as a redfish now, not a speckle. In some places, they're redder than others. I saw a fish up the shore the other night. My wife and I going to New Orleans Saturday to go fishing with Captain Norm, those fish there, oh gosh, they're just bronze looking, okay? Mm-hmm. All right, so we get that center bone out, and then we're gonna come back again, and we do our skinning. Once you kind of get it started, you put it down, and you hold this and kind of seesaw your thing back and forth, and you're wiggling that skin at the same time.
Wiggling the skin.
And then you get that going.
So you're gonna remember all these steps, huh?
No, I'm
yes, I surely am.
This is for the viewers.
You know how many steps?
This is just for the viewers. We're gonna repeat it as I go. All right.
Start off. 13 viewers. Anybody want to ask any questions?
Start off with this one first, even though I cut it back on this side. All right, Matthew. You're up, buddy.
All right.
See if I get all them
Matthew
scales off. So. See, there's a few left, and that's what I talked about.
Taking out the kidney. Now, start
if I remember,
Vince.
Take it down more.
Put your hand kind of on the knife, fish like that. There you go. Now, just take this curve. There you go. Now, seesaw back and forth, just lightly. Whoop! And see,
much.
You went on the other side. Now,
okay.
You'll feel that. Like you have to cut a while to get. Come a little higher. Mm-hmm. You want to be from here back, so you don't. You're actually on the other
side
of that
now?
Bone.
Yeah.
All right. That's okay.
No. So what's my next move?
Go back and go a little higher on it.
Yes, sir. Okay, I think I hit it higher that time.
You still
seesaw a little bit.
Just kind of
seesaw.
He's just a little nervous getting for the first time ever handling a knife like
uh-huh.
that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, come now. Well, are you trying to get, you feeling that edge of that knife hitting that bone?
I am.
All right, that's good. All right, come all the way back here.
Will do.
Now come up a little higher. You're going below. Now you're going on the other side, see?
Oh, yeah.
That's okay.
Yeah. I'm glad I'm making all these mistakes.
No, I have guys that tell me they, there you go.
There you go.
All right.
You learn for your sake, okay. Kind of come up here a little bit.
Yes, sir.
Now, at that point, all right, well, stop. Don't go too deep.
Okay.
Now, on this point here, you see where those bones are coming? You feel them as you go.
On the top side?
Now, you can go for, you can start right here and push forward lightly.
On the top side?
No, push forward.
Okay.
No. Wait a minute. No, you're trying to press through. Just kind of cut through those little rib bones.
Gotcha.
Feel it?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I do feel it.
Feel it? Oh, yeah. And that dish is kind of sliding on you too. That's where I like
there
it.
Is. There okay. We go. I felt
you
it.
Feel
good.
That?
I did.
Okay, now. Go, wait a minute. Whoops, okay. Stop. You're cutting a little bit too deep. All right, now. Take your knife again. Hold your hand. Hold your finger. Now, I'm going to guide you. Just kind of.
Oh, that's, okay, that's a whole
different
feel.
Okay, yeah. Now. Take your knife, and I want you to slowly just kind of feel those bones as you go. Don't go too heavy because the trout's got fine bones.
So you're riding along the top of that bones?
Yep.
And he's taking that all the way to the top.
Now, don't go all the way up. Now, come right here and cut through.
Like this one?
Yep.
All right.
Now, don't bear down. It's all light. Just, all right, cut all the way through.
Gotcha.
Okay, now, stop. Okay. Now, flip it over.
Mm-hmm. This is where we got.
Now, you're going to press down with your left hand. You see where you made that incision right through there? You want to draw that thing, applying pressure with your left hand. You want to draw that knife right along the top of that dorsal fin.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Split it, right?
There you go. Apply pressure. Now just pull it. Just pull it. See?
That moves so easy. That moves so easy.
Okay.
That was really, really painful. Okay. That was so fast.
Keep cutting right there, right? Mm-hmm. It's all about practice and getting the feel of the knife. I mean,
wow.
I don't know how surgeons go in for the first time. Now turn your knife around.
Mm-hmm.
Now pick this up and just push that through. There you go.
That was so easy.
Okay, now here where you, this is the toughest part to learn right here to get off with. You see where you left this meat? Okay, later on you get the feel of how to come up over that dorsal fin and you won't leave any of that meat like most people would with an electric knife. Because that hump and where that knife's sitting is up here and here to here. Okay.
I don't want to leave any.
No, you want to be able to reach through the back. Now lay that down and let's get the dorsal fin. You remember how I told you how to do that?
No, was that?
All right, come down. Put pressure with your left hand, put your index finger here again, and you want to press down flatly. Now you got to remember, this bone goes up into this part of the backbone again. It's all connected. See where you cut a little too deep there, and it was starting to come apart? All right, that's also on that anal fin. Apply pressure down. You're trying to go more on a 45 after.
Okay.
You want to kind of come down more. Almost a 90.
Now try to slice that off?
Yeah, just try to pull it through. Don't cut it off. Slice it because it's joining into the backbone.
Gotcha.
Whoop. Right. Didn't catch that, did you?
No. I'm good.
All right, okay. All right. Now, take your finger.
Mm-hmm.
You feel those little bones right there?
Little bones, right?
Those bones should have been removed when you took that anal fin off of there.
Okay, so these guys need to go.
Right. Well, we'll get that later. So now let's try to see. This is the toughest part. Once you get that other part down, practicing, this will come really easier to learn than doing this side. This side's kind of how I would end up filleting a flounder.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now.
What's the next move?
Now, put your left hand on the fish there, and you want to, now you pull that bone up away from the table, just really kind of let it lay flat, because what you're trying to do here, this bone, which you've already loosened, is going to be a little tougher. This bone and this backbone are actually connected together. So you want to ride your knife over that completely at that joint before you start to go into the rest of the fillet.
All right, so
let me do a half again.
Okay.
And then you can come back and
sounds
watch
good.
One
it
more
may
time.
Have been a couple of minutes since the last time.
Oh, it's yeah, yeah. Okay.
I wonder if you do one move and then he follows the move.
Okay.
You do a move and then you know
what
I mean?
That's a good idea. Okay, now we lay this down.
Okay, again.
Take my index finger again and see how lightly kind of seesaw when I know I won't be below the anal fin, which I told you about a minute ago, right? So then, remember I told you, you take your knife and just hear it cutting, Josh?
Yeah.
And then down. You just draw down. Once you get the feel, see how close we are here? Once you get the feel, that's come through. Then you turn it around, apply pressure with your left hand,
Oh wow, it just peeled right off.
You'll get a feel of it after a while. Will you speed it up? Now on this section again, okay, you were trying to go more like this.
I was 45.
Kind of push it down. See that little wiggle right there? Put it down, almost flat. Pull it through, and that bone in there, which you left up here on the other one,
pulled right
is
out
on the fin. Oh. Okay. Now, on this side, I'm gonna show you this before you start on yours. Again, this is the toughest side, especially now since you've taken that off. Your knife is not like this. Lay it flat again. You gotta kind of get your anatomy of where how those bones connect. Now, if you had gone like we did before, that's all gonna be hanging. You wanna come above that. So then as you come up, come back down on the other side of that vertebrae, pull it through. And then at this point, I'll show you when you go to do it, you just come up straight, and that's it. So then you got a nice pretty fillet.
So then he's just riding the knife on the top of the vertebrae again. Oh wait.
Wow, you can just see right through it.
That's okay. What you want to have. You don't want the birds to get much. There you go. Okay. Alright, so let's pick that up and then we'll get back on the smaller right. bones again.
I feel like I just had a mini study course. Let's see how
now.
I did.
Lay down, that's it, flat. Now always work with this part of your knife.
Start here?
You can start anywhere you want. You can start right there, yeah. Kind of get a feel for it. Whoa!
I'm alright.
Here, I'll tell you what, start back here and work forward. That might be a little easier for you.
Yeah, I think you
just kind of, just get cut through the skin first. Don't have to be too fast, just get the... I realize you've never done this at all before.
Never done it right anyhow.
Yeah.
Well, this just is keep the other going. Thing. Beginners need to... People need to know on YouTube.
Oh, and it feels entirely different this time.
Yeah, just keep kind of going back and forth. Speed will come later. Now, see, you've already gotten that removed.
Yeah, that's how I was wondering okay. if you should go on the other.
I'm going to show you something else. That,
okay.
That,
now, is this when you would cut around this side?
Just keep going above that bone and work over to your tail here.
Will do.
Okay.
All right, now cut off the tail.
Oh, yeah, keep your hand up forward. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Come above that tail a little bit. There you go. Yep, now you're leaving all that meat here. You want that to go in your mouth.
Absolutely.
So come on back a little more when you cut next time, okay?
All right, will do.
Press down.
Yep, I can feel it.
You feel it?
No,
after a while, you'll be able to feel
it. Well, I'm starting to feel the bones
kind
of
like
the knife.
You're brushing your teeth. You know when you're hitting your gums and when you're not, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
The service.
What?
Well, hold on. We're live now. Okay, we're good now. Sorry.
Oh, we're back. So the idea is I'm going to try to get right under these bones here, right?
Yeah, go above them.
Remember what happened that one time when we were at the service. So we apologize, guys, if it's really bad.
All right. Now, am I trying to cut this piece out?
Yeah, keep going now. When you get above that, into the center of the fish, that's when you got that vertebra that's got that hump in it, remember? So you're going to go forward.
He's going to hit
now,
it, isn't he?
No, that's fine. Now, you see that little spot right here? Take this knife now, come above that, and lightly pull it. Feel the bones?
I sure do.
Feel
oh,
it?
Wow, that was that's a real nice feeling.
Right, right.
I don't think my fillet is going to look as good as yours, but I can feel the difference in how it's coming
undone. You just say, first time, and just go right on up.
Look at that.
Yeah, that's a lot better than I've seen some people do it for the first time.
Let me hold mine up just like yours. All right, so this is the beginner.
I
see a couple of bites in there.
There we go.
There's
there
the bacon.
Go. That's good.
Or you get to throw it to the fish. They're going to come to the birds.
All right, now, I'm going to show you something here real quick. Now, let me put these few fillets out of the way, and I want to show you, but then I'm going to come back, and I'm going to show you how to take the small bones out.
Okay.
But I'm going to show you how we used to, all right, Josh, let me scale these real quick. I want to show you a lot of people, like, they want the bones in the fish when they eat them. Right? Some people, it's chicken tastes better, one thing and another, if the bones are in it. But now, let me get this one out of the way, and I'm going to bring it to that point, and I'm going to show you what I'm talking about. How we would clean it. If somebody didn't want that backbone, they wanted that backbone on their fish, this is what we would do in the market years ago. And a lot of people will buy whiting and they want them, they'll call a head off and split and they'll lay it open like a book. And that's another thing we can do. I can actually show you how much meat we can get out of a small whiting. Okay, we'll take this, come back, it'll all be repetitious. We'll cut the head off here, there, and we'll go again.
It's not repetitious because people need to know.
Now, oh, this is interesting. Now, let me show you something. And the more you get into the winter time, this all of these fish so far have been females. This is a male. Come around on this side.
Yes, sir.
All right, now as I go to take this out, you notice that this one has this bladder-like in it.
Mm-hmm.
You take your thumb and kind of put it under it. Now in the wintertime, it's a little harder to remove. You got to kind of take your knife and run it. Like in the summertime, here we are,
I see it like
November.
Didn't even get up to the kidney and the blood.
Yeah,
yet.
Now see that? Right, now see this?
Oh, we're sorry, yeah.
This right here comes out. See? Now that's in the male fish. That's how you can tell your male from your female. And the more we get into the winter months, the harder that liner is to be removed. Now, Heather, I was telling you before, we come back just lightly. Just do this. See, I'm kind of slow getting through those few bones. Then I come up. And at this point, just, you're almost kind of hearing me cutting through it. Then when you get to that point, remember that hump I told you again? You pull it down. Around, pressure on your left hand, just pull it in a little seesaw motion. Now, a lot of times we take a fish, they want to head off and split. We take this off. Now, we wouldn't remove the bone. People wanted that bone in it. We lay it down, we take this, and we run like that. And then we take our knife, hold it here, and do that.
Oh, wow.
And that's that hard section right here. See how those little bones are right there? That's the hard section that runs into that backbone. And that is a booger to get. Now, but what you can do if you want to take it off, this is where it really takes it. You can almost see my knife blade coming through those bones. You come this way.
So can you take it off from this side?
Yep, you can take it off from this side if you want to do it. It's a little slower. Just come up like that.
That's what you're doing, but you're just coming from the
right.
Bottom when you're
coming this way. So that gives you a feel of what that backbone looks like. So at that point, you got to be where those two connect together. Mm-hmm. And at that point, that's where your difference comes in. And then, all right, now let's go back on this one, and you take the smaller bones out. All right.
Oh, yeah.
You remember how I told you?
No.
Let me
show them again.
Yeah. No, it's,
yeah.
All right.
We
let me
do this again. There's a lot of steps there.
That's what I was laughing. And both sides are different. My brother and I were having a race one day, and he said, all right, we'll see who take the little bones out the fastest. Well, he reached down and grabbed this side of the fillet. This side's faster to do than this side. I said, no. And I'll show you why. Right. Now, take that blade again, and we'll show you. Underneath
it. What are these bones? Explain to
them. These are the rib cage.
Rib cage.
Come down.
Start with the rib cage.
And then come up in there. Draw a fine line that breaks that membrane on that skin and just pull them all out. There they are right there. Okay?
Right, Matthew, let's see you do that same thing on the bad one. On the bad one. Do it on the bad one.
Okay.
All right, rib cage.
Then just turn the knife up.
Go that way. All right. Tell him what he's
telling
you. No, turn your knife that way. Mm-hmm. There you go. And then you want to kind of, now you can keep it well. You won't, there you go. Yeah, that's good. Next time you'll end up having your hand a little more on the, go down a little deeper. A little deeper. Go all the way through. You see the bones where you're trying to work with? You do have that one where we didn't gut it and the bladder's left in.
Now what's the best way to?
No, you were right. Come from this side.
Mm-hmm.
Now just you wanna kind of make that knife blade become an extension of your finger, and that's why your index finger's on that part of the knife, okay?
I think I'm getting close to getting the bones out, but my piece won't be as pretty as your piece.
That's okay.
Stop him. Right,
now,
tell him to stop.
Yeah, well, he's pulling them that way because that meat's soft, which is different. Okay, you got to come up in here. See, put your finger right there. Feel those?
Mm-hmm, sure do.
All right.
So rib cage first.
Yeah, now then you want to come in. Those bones are out, okay? Well, there's one right here.
Got to get him to.
Let me hold the knife. Come up underneath it and just pull that one bone out. Okay, now You want to get those bones on the high side. Now, they aren't visible like the other ones, but can you see that little teeny line right there?
Yes,
it kind of comes up from way back here, and it goes all the way up there.
Fish.
If you clean a mackerel and all, they're going to be straight down, but they're going to be farther and deeper into the fillet.
What bones are they?
I don't know. I guess it's all part of the rib cage, but it's inner bones, and they'll go on this top side. Now, what you want to do, Matthew, is you want to cut right along here, and then you want to take your knife from the top and pull on the other side of those bones. And just you can kind of put your finger right there. Feel that.
I feel it right there.
Okay, now if we had a red here today, you could really feel it because it's a much tougher bone. And just cut on this side of the bone first. There's about five or six of them that run down in there, and then cut on the other side.
And you're gonna try to do that.
All right. So and I start the incision where?
All right. Now take your knife. Let me bring it in here for Josh. Take your knife, like here. Come back. On like in there and cut down. All right, that's far enough. To cut forward a little bit more. Cut up in here. Push forward. Now, you went on the other side of it. Right? Now cut this side.
All right. Just a little bit, right?
Yeah. Now, all right, we'll stop. Now, you're getting it, but
I'm missing some meat there.
Yeah, too much meat. You feel right here? Like with practice,
I can see all that.
With practice, you'll get the feel. Now, cut down a little deeper in here.
All right.
If it was easy, everybody would do it.
All right, we'll stop. All right, now, take this knife and hold it up like this, and take your knife, and I want you to hold it like this, like a pair of pliers, and pinch it and pull it back.
Okay.
And the more you do, the more, this will give you more excuse to,
no,
take your thumb. No, right. You cut on this side, you cut on that side, then you hold your meat back with your hand and take your thumb and you pinch it right here and you pull it back.
Gotcha.
I tried it.
Yes, sir.
Just want to apologize everybody for this Wi-Fi if it's bad. Yep.
This is what I'm supposed to be taking out?
Yep, that's good. All right, come on back. That's enough.
Okay.
You got you far enough back. So you've got all the bones out of those but the collarbone.
Mm-hmm.
You feel it? You don't
I'm
feel
just,
any?
I'm just checking it out, making sure I agree. Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's it.
All right.
Anyway, that's that. Now, you want to skin this one? Try to skin it?
Sure.
All right, let's pull this out. I'm going to go ahead and take this off of here. We're going to have all the bones out.
Yeah, a collar?
Yeah, we just got rid of that collarbone. Okay, Matthew.
Just watch it.
Yeah, take that.
So this is the most important thing. If I was going to do this, what's the most important thing to get out of the fish?
Lay this back flat. Wait a minute, Josh. All right, now go ahead. Seesaw back and forth. Can you feel the skin and the flesh separating?
I can a little bit.
All right, keep going. Now hold that knife a little bit more like that. There you go. You're not cutting through the skin. You're just kind of scraping along it, okay? All right, now stop. Now try to grab the skin. Hold on to the skin and wiggle the skin and knife kind of back and forth at the same time. There you go. There you go. There you go. Good. Good. Put a little bit more angle on the blade of the knife. Hold the skin. Don't worry about the flesh.
Okay.
All right, hold it. Seesaw back and forth.
So far, it feels actually pretty good. Like I'm not destroying it.
Too bad. Like you're not cutting through, yeah.
Right.
Keep
going. I'm trying to go as slow
put
as I can.
A little more angle.
Try to save all the meat I can.
Yeah, that's right. That's good. Yeah. Presto. Wow. That's pretty damn good for your first time. Look at that.
First one.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir. I was trying to watch you closely. You're not a bad teacher, Captain.
All about getting the feel. Now, a lot of people, God, that took a lot. But once you get that anatomy down, I mean, like on this one, I cut in. Cut back on it. See, I'm trying to stay as close as possible because I want the customer to go home with a lot of fish to eat because they paid for it. I don't want to throw their meat down the garbage, I suppose.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it. And you know, yeah, let's do this one again. All right, go at it.
Yes, sir.
Seesaw back and forth.
Hey, Vince, you know what I want to do a video on?
What's that?
Is
a little bit more angle here. There you
Thank
go.
You.
I want to do a video on.
All right, stop and grab your skin.
Yes, sir.
You can do it without it, but that tool.
I know, I think it's a good starter tool, especially
right.
for safety.
Hold a minute. See, now I can see a bone that I left right there. Sight and feel is very important. You don't want the child to choke on the bone.
Amen to that.
Okay, now hold that skin and Go a little faster this time. Just a little bit. There you go. Put a little more angle on you. You want to be able to start to feel that skin, okay? Keep going. Now, electric knife, they're going fast and all, but it's still not getting the meat return.
We should do a video on you and an electric knife.
Oh, I got video on my buddy Walker.
No, you doing it.
Oh, I've never done one with an electric knife, guys.
Exactly. That would be a good, that'd be some good.
Fish out of water once.
Yeah, exactly. Right.
We'll be on the same page.
Well, I saw a guy one day doing it, and all of a sudden he hollered and screamed, and he threw the knife overboard. I said, what are you doing? He got shocked.
Oh, shit.
Let me see the other side of that. Excellent, excellent. Look at that, Josh.
That's
skin. He's better on his skin than I thought he was going to be. I thought he was going to cut right through the skin, but that's great. Yeah, that's a good job.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Josh, what do you want to do?
That's about it.
I mean, I feel like we've got probably a pretty good 30 minutes at least.
Oh, you'll be surprised. so I just want to, thanks for watching, everyone. Remember to hit that bell. We apologize if the Wi-Fi has been kind of spotty out here. We don't look alive. We get the Wi-Fi freezing. So, Vince, you're going to finish this up. Make sure you hit that bell. Subscribe if you like what you're seeing. Please comment below if you have any questions. And also, Vince will have all these tools of his trade. We'll be on Amazon, his influencer page, if you follow the link below.
It'll be on our website, cleanyourcatch.com.
Oh, yeah, don't forget, cleanyourcatch.com. Am I forgetting anything else, Vince?
That's about it. We'll come back with other fish later, and you can kind of watch me take these bones out. This is the opposite side. I didn't get Matthew to do this one. And trust me, I have so many people that call me and email me and tell me, man, I was about to give up, and all of a sudden it started getting easier because I was getting a feel of it. You know, it's just like, I don't know what I can compare it to. I mean,
I think we need to break it down more with graphics to exactly what I need to clean.
See, I did just using my fingernails here, but just that's it. Fat, no bone, no gristle.
All right, thanks everyone. Thanks for watching.